NanoLuc is an extraordinarily small and bright luciferase, ideally suited as a protein reporter. NanoLuc is also capable of transferring energy to fluorescent molecules that it comes into close contact with. We call this process bioluminescence resonance energy transfer, or NanoBRET. What makes NanoBRET useful is that NanoLuc has to be in very close proximity to the fluorescent molecule for energy transfer to occur, like the binding of a protein to another protein, or the binding of a protein to a drug. When the fluorophore is attached to a drug that is capable of producing NanoBRET, we refer to these molecules as NanoBRET tracers. The really powerful feature of NanoBRET is that these tracers can bind to other surfaces inside the cell, but the only signal that is generated when the tracer binds to the NanoLuc fusion protein. But why would we want to measure the binding of a NanoBRET tracer to a target protein inside a cell? The answer is that the tracer is merely a tool to monitor the binding of non-fluorescent drugs to the target protein. Here's how we would set up a NanoBRET experiment to measure drug binding. First, we would tag NanoLuc to the protein of interest and express this inside cells. Next, we would introduce NanoBRET tracers that would go inside cells and bind to a site on the target protein. This would produce a NanoBRET signal. However, if we introduce increasing concentrations of a drug that binds to the same target, we are able to compete with the tracer, resulting in a decrease in NanoBRET. This allows us to measure the affinity of the drug to the target. It also allows us to compare the relative affinities of different drugs to that same target. This technology allows us to measure drug-target interactions in very complex environments where drugs commonly need to bind, such as the inside of living cells. For more information about designing assays to study protein-ligand interactions using NanoBRET, visit promega.com/nanoluc.